हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप ऑल द डिटेल्स आर वेरी क्लियर विथ यू रिगार्डिंग व्हाट इज टर्जिडिटी, व्हाट इज फ्लैसिडिटी, ऑस्मोसिस, देन व्हाट इज प्लास्मोलिसिस। आई होप दीज कंसेप्ट आर वेरी क्लियर विथ यू, बिकॉज टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू गो अहेड विथ अ न्यू कंसेप्ट दैट्स कॉल्ड एज अ रूट प्रेशर। सो वी आर कमिंग टूवर्ड्स द रूट प्रेशर। सो the other day we discussed that what is actually root pressure, wherein I told you that root pressure is nothing but the pressure which is developed because of the roots. And how is this pressure developed because of the roots? Is because of the cell to cell osmosis process. Okay, because of the cell to cell osmosis process, okay, there is a kind of a root pressure which gets developed. And also we discussed in that, in the same way, that there is something called as the ascent of sap. Okay, what is the ascent of sap? Ascent of sap is nothing but the movement of water and the minerals, okay, movement of water and minerals in the plant through the xylem. Okay, so when we define root pressure, we say that root pressure is the pressure which is developed in the roots, okay, due to the continued inward movement of water, that is through the cell-to-cell osmosis, which helps in the ascent of the sap upward through the xylem. So this is what is called as the root pressure. Now here there is a small example, or we can say an experiment, which is given on root pressure. So in that experiment they are saying that if you want to remove a particular plant, okay, when you are just uprooting, okay, when you are just uprooting the plant, you will find like a pressure which is created to uproot the plant. That particular pressure is nothing but the root pressure. This is due to the root pressure. Now how is this root pressure developed? Is I have just drawn a small little diagram for that, okay, you just a small little for the explanation. Now when the root pressure is taking place, what happens? It is due to cell osmosis. Okay, now cell to cell osmosis, right? Now here the cell will become turgid because of the process of osmosis. So it will be pushing the second cell. Okay, it will be pushing the second cell. Why? Because it has become turgid now, it is swollen. So it will exert a push on the second cell. Similarly, the second cell is also turgid, so it will push on the third cell. So what happens because of this pushing is the water which is there, okay, the water which is there, it reaches inside. So how? As we will go through the context, that is on page 47. Root pressure is built due to cell-to-cell osmosis in the root tissue. As one of the turgid cell presses, okay, the next cell, the force of the flow of water increases inwards. Now water is absorbed by the roots itself, right? So because of this, the water which is there, it gets inside. Where inside? Inside the roots. Okay, so slowly and slowly, because of the cell-to-cell osmosis, it will be moving towards the xylem. So it will be reaching, so when water reaches, where does it reach? It reaches the xylem channels. Okay, when it reaches the xylem, it will pass through the thick walls, pores of the thick walls of the particular channels, and then it with a particular force, it will reach upwards. Okay, it will reach upwards. So root pressure is one of the forces. So root pressure is one of the forces which is responsible for the water. Okay, root pressure, we can say it is responsible for the water from the roots to the stem. So mainly who is in focus for this is the root pressure. So root pressure is basically responsible for sending the water from the roots upwards to the stem by the channel which is called as the xylem channel. Okay, we have studied about xylem also in details in 7th. Okay, what is xylem? Even I think so in 8th or 9th also you have studied about what is xylem vessels, right? So this is the process which is taking place. So root pressure, what do we say? It is because of the cell-to-cell osmosis. Because of the cell-to-cell osmosis, the water reaches inside. There's a flow of water. Water enters the xylem. It enters the pores of thick walls with force. And finally, we can say that it will be reaching out to the stem as well as to the leaves and plants. So there's a small diagram which is given. Diagrammatic cross-section of the part of the root showing the arrows. Cell-to-cell conduction of water from a root hair to xylem. So see, you can see the root hairs. From the root hairs, the water has been entering over here. Then you can say it is passing over here from the it's passing cell to cell osmosis, and then finally it is reaching the xylem, and then you can see the thick walls, and finally the stem part. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the root pressure, to understand root pressure. Now next topic is called as guttation. I hope root pressure is clear. Now next topic, which is called as guttation. Now what is this guttation? Is that in some plants like tomato, grass, banana or ferns, here what happens is the root pressure is too much, okay, it is very high, okay, and because of the root pressure, what will happen? Because of the root pressure, it will flow towards the stem, okay, after going towards the stem, where it will flow, so this is the stem, it will be flowing to the leaves, okay, leaves veins, so it will be flowing to the leaf veins. So what is observed is that there is some small water droplets on these leaves. Okay, there are some water which is there, it appears as a tiny droplets on the margin, especially in the early morning, and this process is called as gutation. So what happens from the stem, okay, the root pressure will be more, so more and more water will be sent here, so from the veins the water will enter, and on the leaves small droplets of water are seen, especially early in the morning, and that is called as gutation. Okay, about gutation we will be studying more, that means why these droplets are present, okay, we will be studying in chapter 5.12, figure 5.12, next lesson we will be studying it in more detail. So just we will understand that there are some droplets which are seen, and that is nothing but gutation. Okay, then here the progress check we can do. State of the cell when it cannot accommodate any more water, what is it called as? It's turgid cell or turgidity. Pressure of the cell contents on the cell wall, so that's called as turgor pressure, right? Then condition that is opposite to turgid, flaccid, okay, or flaccidity. State of the plasmolyzed cell after re-entry of water, deplasmolysis. And pressure under which the water passes from the living cell to the root into xylem is what? It's the root pressure. Okay, this was a progress check. Now next point is, what is the importance of the root hairs and the upward movement of absorbed water and minerals? So here, what is the importance? Why is root hairs present and what does it do? What is it doing for the roots? Okay, so we will be seeing one by one. So absorption of water by roots. So how, if I say that the root hairs are absorbing the water, how does this process takes place? Okay, so we will see that. Now here I have small diagrammatic representation I have done. So here we can just, I'll just explain. First of all, the root hair has cell sac. Everybody is clear with cell sac. What is cell sac? The vacuoles which contain water. Now here the root hair which has cell sac is at a very high concentration. Okay, and then now the root hairs have absorbed certain water. So how they will be absorbing this water? So outside water is there, right? There is water outside surrounding the root hair. So this water is at low concentration. This is at high concentration. So this low concentration water will go to the high concentration by the process of osmosis, right? So water has entered. As the water enters, what happens? The cells become turgid, right? The cells start becoming turgid. As the cells become turgid, they will push one cell to the other, one cell to the other, and in this process what we did, and then what will happen? Water will reach inside. So they will be pushing the cells, and then the water will be reaching inside, and then where it will flow? It will flow to the xylem. And again, from the xylem where it will be flowing towards the stem, towards the leaves. So we can say absorption of water by the root. How is this process? How is this process taking? Once again, root hairs are there. Root hairs contain cell sac, which is at a very high concentration. Outside water is at low concentration. Because of the process of osmosis, from the low concentration to high concentration, in presence of semi-permeable membrane, osmosis will take place. Cells are going to become turgid. Cells become turgid. From here, they will be pushing the water. Water will be entering the xylem, from the xylem to the stem, and then again to the leaves. So this is what is explained in this process. Okay, that is, root hair contains cell sap, which is at high concentration as compared to outside water. This different sets of osmosis, right? Osmosis takes place. Outside water, where it will be diffuse in the root hair. From the cell-bearing root hair, water will continuously pass to the adjoining cells, as I did here. Finally, and then it will get to the xylem vessels. Okay, and then we say the next point, the turgidity. Okay, the turgidity, can you see the cells have become turgid? Because of the turgidity acquired by the cells, the process helps to push the water upwards through the xylem vessels, and because of this turgid pressure they are pushed upwards. So I hope this part is clear. Now next is the absorption of mineral elements. How are the minerals absorbed? Now absorption of minerals, which is there, it is taking place because of the process of active transport. Okay, so here, because of the active transport, so here water minerals are absorbed by active transport. That is from where? From a low concentration to a high concentration. So dilute solution of water and mineral salts are absorbed by the roots. Okay, they are absorbed from the xylem, but by the process of active transport, that is from low to high concentration. So here you can see the process. They have again explained the root hairs. If you see, this is the root hairs. the film of soil around the particles, the root hairs are absorbing it. Now where are they sending? They are sending it to the xylem vessel and from the xylem vessel to the stem. Now here, the dilute solution of water and mineral salts absorbed by the soil by the roots can be used in manufacture of food in the leaves only if they can travel to the highest points of the plant, and this upward flow occurs from the xylem only. So here also absorption of water, minerals and all, it is taking place how? It is taking place by the process of active transport, and mineral elements are absorbed. So they can be reaching. So the solution of dilute solution will be reaching upwards by the process of, from the xylem into the highest points of the plant. Okay, I hope these two things are clear. Root pressure, we did root pressure as well as what is the importance of root hairs. Okay, there we saw absorption of water as well as we saw absorption of minerals. Okay, absorption of minerals. Then we also saw what is gutation. Now there are some experiments. Okay, we are going to see one by one the experiments. So first experiment is that to show that the roots are absorbing water. So we are proving how these absorption and everything is taking place. So first we are proving that how these roots are absorbing water. So for that you need to take a control setup. Control setup is just for comparison. So here you can see there that this is the control setup. You have to take one test tube, you have to put water in that test tube and a little oil on the top. Why we are putting oil is so that evaporation of water does not take place. Okay, so here I have the test tube, a little amount of oil on the top, and you have to keep the test tube. Then you have to take test tube B. Okay, in test tube B, what you are supposed to do is same thing. You are supposed to take water, oil, and you have to take one balsam plant. Okay, the balsam plant, young leafy balsam plant, you have to see that its root are inserted inside the test tube. Okay, and the same setup, water and oil on the top. And you have to keep this undisturbed for at least 2 days. Okay, for these two test tubes, after a day or two, you have to keep it undisturbed. So after 1-2 days, you will see that what happens over here is the level of the water in test tube B has reduced, but test tube A will be no change. Here the level of the water in the test tube has reduced. Now can you tell me the reason why? Because the water is absorbed by the roots. Okay, the water which is present is absorbed by the roots for the growth. So this experiment proves that roots absorb the water. Here there is no change, nothing happened to over here because we have not put anything into it, no plant in it. But in test tube B there was a little reduction of water. There was a reduction of water because of the process, that is the roots are absorbing the water. Fine. Now let us go to the second experiment. Second experiment is to show water is conducted upwards through xylem. Now here what are we supposed to do is you are supposed to take one balsam plant. Okay, after taking the balsam plant, you have to put that balsam plant in a beaker. Okay, you have to take the balsam plant and you have to put it in a beaker, and this beaker is should have the eosin solution in it. Eosin solution, it's an indicator. Okay, just to give a pink color to the roots. Okay, now if you see that the eosin solution is added to it, now the roots are also become pink in color if you see, and you have to keep this for 3-4 hours. Okay, at least for 3-4 hours you keep this experiment in the experimental setup. Now what will you observe here is afterwards, after you take it, you just take the you take this roots, okay, and you wash it in water, with water, as well as the stem and the leaves also, everything you wash with water. Okay, then you do a transverse section. Okay, transverse section, what is a transverse section? Transverse section is cutting it horizontally. Okay, cut this transverse section horizontally. So you will observe that root has become, there is a pink color in the root, there is a pink color in the xylem tissue stem. On the leaf also there is a pink color. So how did this pink color come? Okay, this proves that what happens, the xylem which is there, it will be conducting the water from the roots to the stem and from the roots to the leaves. So this proves that water is conducted upwards through the xylem. Water is conducted upwards through the xylem. Okay, then so this is how the process takes place. Now here they have given about vascular bundles in the stem. What are the vascular tissue? You know what are the vascular tissue? Those are xylem and phloem. The vascular tissue are xylem and phloem. So here you can see that the vascular bundles in the stem, root, leaf, stalks are continuously, they will be forming an unbroken, so we can see that like they are like the waves. So xylem which is there, it will be conducting only water and salt. okay, but phloem which is there, it will be conducting the food substances up and down, okay, up and down. So here let us see another experiment, which is conduction of water through xylem. So here what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to take two leafy shoots, okay, two leafy shoots. Now what are we supposed to do here is, we are supposed to grind out, okay, outer part of this particular in part A, and here you have to make a small ring. This is called as the keeping this, you have to make a small ring over here, okay, and this process is called as girdling, okay. This process is called as the girdling. So you can say that keeping the central part intact, okay, this is the ringing experiment which is called as girdling. So here you have keep it as girdling, and but here you have made a small little hole over here. Now after some times, what will you observe? You have to leave this setup, okay. You will see that here the plant's leaves are quite intact, nothing has happened. But if you see here, the leaves are down, they are wilted. Now what is the reason? Because the xylem which is there, it is located centrally and it is deep under the roots. But here if you see that whatever material, whatever food material is left over here, it cannot pass over here, it cannot pass through the leaves, and that is the reason these leaves are wilted. But these leaves are growing properly, even though the outer part is which is there, it's removed, the phloem is removed, then also the leaf is living properly. So a twig with phloem removed and xylem intact, that's why the leaves are intact. B twig with the xylem which is removed and the phloem intact, so the leaves have wilted. So this proves, what does it prove? Conduction of water takes place through xylem, okay. So this is the experiment number 3. Then experiment number 4, what are we supposed to do in experiment number 4? Now in experiment number 4, the same thing, you have to cut a ring, okay. You have to cut a ring, that means you have to cut a ring around this around this plant, okay. And you can see that it is deep into the ground, so you can take any potted plant like a guava, okay, and penetrate the phloem and cambium, but not the xylem girdling. So you can see, so you can see that a plant is over here, okay. This part of the stem is removed, okay, and you are supposed to observe. So what you will observe is that after some time or after few days, that this part of the stem, if you see, it is swollen. Why? Because lot of food is accumulated in this. What is phloem doing? Phloem which is there, okay, it will be sending the food outwards and downwards, right? That is what the phloem is doing. So here if you see, this particular phloem only is removed from it. So you can see that the food will be all gathered over here, the stored food will be gathered here. So here you will see that the upwards part of the stem will be growing very nicely, but the deeper part which is there, maybe it can start getting, see, if you see, it will start getting decayed or there will be no growth. Why? Because nothing is reaching down, right? No, there is no movement. Xylem is providing the food upwards, okay. Xylem is sending, because xylem is intact, xylem will be sending. But what is about phloem? Phloem, all the food will be gathered here. So this part may be even getting died, or it will be stopped growing, okay. This part will stop growing, or even it may die. Eventually only the upper part of the plant will be growing properly, the down part will be dead. So you can say that whatever phloem is doing, phloem is transferring the food up and down. So starting you can see like this, and at the end you can see here a swollen base, and here everything is getting decayed. So this proves that food, okay, from the leaves is conducted downwards through the phloem in the stem, and conduction of water is taking place through the xylem. So I hope all these 4 experiments are very, very clear with you. First experiment showing that roots absorb water. Second experiment, water is conducted upwards through xylem. Third, conduction of water through xylem. And fourth, that is showing the food from the leaves is conducted downwards through the phloem in the stem. So here we have few progress checks. So they are saying that look at figure 4.15. Why was oil added? Because it prevents evaporation. Look at experiment number shown in figure 4.16. Why is eosin necessary? To show that it's that coloring, okay, the cells are transparent, so you can't see, so just to dye the plant. Which part of the stem, the xylem or phloem, is located deeper internally? That's the xylem. Look at the figure 4.18. Why has the stem below the ring stopped growing and even slightly decayed? Why? Because of the phloem, which is transferring the food up and down through the stem. So with this we finish this particular part of the experiments. Okay, now the last part which is there, which is called as the forces contributing to the ascent of sap, which is a root pressure, capillarity, transpiration and pull, and adhesion. Okay, this we will be doing it in the next half, which will be the last part of the lesson, and along with that we will just if you have any queries you can just ask me. So please go through it very nicely. Thank you and take care, dear students.